Hello everyone. In this OpenShot tutorial, I'm gonna show you how to add blur effects to a video. There are two types of blur effects available in OpenShot, the soft blur and the pixelated blur. The soft blur effect can only be applied to the entire video, and is usually used for transition, either between two scenes or at the start of the video. The pixelated blur effect, on the other hand, can be applied to the entire video as well as to certain part of the video only. It's usually used to hide a subject or an object in the video, such as a person's face, visually disturbing scene, or some information that shouldn't be exposed to the viewers. As an exercise, we're gonna add both types of blur effects to this video, where we're gonna add a soft blur as transition at the start of the video, and then add pixelated blurs to hide this cafe's name and this guy's face. The edited video will look like this. And as you might have noticed, the pixelated blur that covers this guy's face follows his movement to keep hiding his face. Alright, let's start the exercise with adding the soft blur effect to the video, and then show its properties. If the properties panel is still closed, right-click the blur effect icon, and then click properties. As you can see here on the video preview, with the blur effects properties are all at their default values, we have a blur like this. To get the desired blur effect, we'll need to adjust the effect properties values accordingly. Out of these six properties, we are only interested in the horizontal radius, iterations, and the vertical radius. To see how these three properties work, let me first set the iterations to 0. So as you can see here, an iterations value of 0 will remove the blur effect from the video. Similarly, if I set both the horizontal and vertical radii to 0 while setting the iterations to non-zero, it will also remove the blur effect. Now if I set the horizontal radius to a non-zero value, we'll get a blur effect similar to those caused by shaky camera or fast-moving object in the horizontal direction. Likewise, a combination of non-zero vertical radius and zero horizontal radius will result in similar blur effect but in the vertical direction. And then if I set both properties to non-zero, we'll get a softer blur. To get an even softer blur, we can increase the value of the iterations property. But please take note that a higher iterations value will cause OpenShot to take longer time to generate the blur effect for the video preview. And then another thing to take note is that these three properties are keyframe properties, meaning that their values can be interpolated to animate the blur effect. So make sure that the playhead is at the right position before changing any of these properties' values. Alright, so to use this blur effect as transition at the start of the clip, we'll have to animate it for a certain duration. For this exercise, let's make it slowly fade out within the first 2 seconds of the video. So first, position the playhead at the start of the clip. And then we'll set the radii both to 25, and the iterations to 10, to get the soft blur we had just now. After that, position the playhead at the 2-second mark of the timeline ruler. Then set both radii to 0. And then to make the blur fades out slowly in the beginning and faster towards the end of its 2-second duration, we'll set the radii interpolation modes to Bezier Ease In. Now let's play the video to see the result. Alright, now let's add a pixelated blur effect to hide this cafe's name. So first click and drag the pixelate effect to the clip, and then show its properties. Since the cafe's name is static and appears throughout the whole video, we'll only need to set this pixelated blur effect's properties once, which is at the beginning of the clip. So now move the playhead to the start of the clip. And as you can see here, we have two overlapping blur effects at the start of the clip. So to make it easier working on this pixelated blur effect, let's first temporarily disable the soft blur effect we added earlier by setting its iterations property to 0. Now show the pixelated effect's properties by clicking its icon on the clip. We are going to set the bottom, left, right, and top margins such that the blur covers only the cafe's name. To make the pixel size smaller, we can reduce the pixelization property's value to a smaller one, say 0.3. Okay, now if we play the video, we should have the cafe's name blurred throughout the video. Alright, the last blur effect that we're gonna add to this video is a pixelated blur to hide this guy's face. This blur effect should only appear when the guy is about to turn his head. And it should be made follow his movement as he steps forward and backward. To achieve this dynamic blur effect, first let's add another pixelate effect to the clip. Then move the playhead to the start of the clip by clicking the previous key point button on the timeline toolbar. After that, show its properties and set any one of its margin properties to 1. This will hide or disable the blur until we show it at some point in the middle of the clip later. Now position the playhead at the frame where the guy is about to turn his head. Then set the 4 margin properties until we have a pixelated blur that hides the guy's face. We may also reduce the pixelization property's value to make the pixel size smaller. Now here's an important thing to pay attention to. If I drag the playhead left and then right, we can see that the blur starts to appear even before its intended start time, as if it's moving down from above the guy's head. This is because the interpolation modes of the margin properties are still linear, which means that the margin properties' values over this period are interpolated linearly based on the initial values at the start of the clip and the final values at this point. To fix this problem, we have to change the margin's interpolation modes to constant, so that the margin's values over this period remain constant at their initial values, which are set at the start of the clip. Now if we play the video, the blurs should appear instantly at the intended time. Alright, now let's make the blur follows the guy's face as he steps forward and backward. To make the blur move to the left, first position the playhead at the frame where the guy is about to step forward. Then go to the pixelate effects properties, and insert this frame as keyframe into the left margin and the right margin. After that, move the playhead to the frame where the guy's head reaches its leftmost position on the screen. Then go back to the pixelate properties and set the left and right margins until the blur covers his face completely. We can leave the interpolation modes linear as the guy's face movement speed is relatively constant. Now to make the blur follows his face while he's stepping backward, first position the playhead at the frame where his face is completely hidden behind the other guy. Then go back to the properties panel and adjust the left and right margins accordingly. And finally, to remove or disable this blur effect when it's not needed anymore, first position the playhead a few frame after this key point. Then go back to the properties panel, and set either the left margin or the right margin to 1. Okay, it's all set. Now let's enable the soft blur effect we disabled just now, and then play the video from the very beginning. Alright, so that's how easy it is to add blur effects to a video in OpenShot. I hope you find this tutorial useful, and thank you for watching.